Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in Revit 2018 Imperial. In the previous tutorial, we learned how to exclude a rectangle, how to offset object and grid layer. We'll continue this tutorial where we stop. So to follow along, go and open the previous file where you saved it, or go and download the file 00.006_DIAB from the website. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save as button. Rename the file to 00.007_DIAB and click the save button. Let's go and create an opening for the doors and windows. To do that, go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and make the 2D wall layer as the current layer. Now go to the Home tab, Draw panel, and select the line command. Zoom in into this area. Use the midpoint object snap and snap to the midpoint of this line. Move to the perpendicular opposite. Move to the opposite line. When you see the perpendicular object snap, click. Press escape to get out of the corner. Zoom out and zoom in into this area. Press enter to start the line command again. Use the midpoint object snap to place and the perpendicular object snap to draw a short line in between these lines. Press escape to get out of the corner. Now zoom out and zoom in into this area. Start the line command. We want to draw a line in between of this point, but we have an end point here, but this line continues from this point to this point. So if we want to use the midpoint object snap, the midpoint object snap to the mid of the entire line. That is not what we want. So all you need to do in a situation like this, hold down your shift key and right click and select this option, mid between two points. When you do, you can use different object snap to complete this task. Now AutoCAD prompts you for the first midpoint. Let's click this endpoint. Then AutoCAD prompts you again for the second midpoint. Let's click place this point. So AutoCAD places us in the midpoint of the two lines that we just specified. Now click to place the line. Press escape to get out of the command. Press enter again. Repeat the same method by holding down your shift key and right click. Select mid between two points, snap from this point for the first midpoint and this point for the second midpoint. AutoCAD start the line between the two points that you specified. Use the perpendicular object snap and snap to this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Zoom out and zoom in into this area. Start the line command. Use the midpoint object snap and the midpoint object snap again, or the perpendicular object snap. Press enter to end the command. Go to the Home tab, Draw panel, and select the line command. Zoom in into this area, avoid your mouse cursor and move down slowly. You see a plus sign where you avoid the mouse cursor. Now type 1 foot on your keyboard and press enter. AutoCAD start the line 1 foot away from the point where you place your temporal line. Now use the perpendicular object snap and click. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 3 feet on your keyboard and press enter. Offset this line to the right and offset this line to both left and right. Offset this line up and down. Offset this line both left and right. Offset this line up and down. Press escape to get out of the command. Select the offset command again. Type 2 feet 6 inches and press enter. Offset this line down and offset this line to the left. Select this line, move to the right. Type 1 foot 6 inches, press enter. Now go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the Fillet command. Type M for the multiple option and test cancel. Select this line, this line, this line, this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the line command. Use the midpoint object snap and snap to the midpoint of this line. Zoom in and use the perpendicular object snap and snap to this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 3 feet on your keyboard and press enter. Offset this line to the right and offset it to the left. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, modify panel and select the trim command. Press enter. Trim off this area to grate the opening for the windows and the doors. Select this object. You can use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out by rolling it forward or backward. Press escape to get out of the command. Zoom in into this area and go to the home tab, modify panel, select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 4 feet on your keyboard and press enter. Offset this line 4 feet to the left. Select the line again, move to the right and type 3 feet on your keyboard, press enter. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select the trim command, press enter. Hold down your shift key and extend this line. Now release the shift key, click this line. Press escape. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the trim command again. Press enter. Trim this line. Press escape. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the match property button. At the prompt, select source object. Select this line as a source object. At the prompt, select destination object. Select this line. Press escape to get out of the code. In fact, I'm going to delete all this line because you cannot have a step. If we don't delete, then the step will block the entrance into this room. Now, select all of this line. This and click the delete key on your keyboard. Select the fillet command, select this line and this line. Now zoom in and out and delete all the reference line used. This line, we just use them as reference line to create the opening of the windows and door. So now that you have completed some of this opening, you need to select and erase them to clean up the drawing. Go to the home tab, layer panel and click the make current button. Select the kitchen layer. Start the line command. Start a line from this point to the end this point. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, modify panel and click the down arrow after modify. Select the break command. At the prompt, select object. Select this object. Then at the specifying break point, move the mouse cursor into any point in this area and click AutoCAD break the line. Now use the fillet command. Type M for the multiple option and press the space bar. In AutoCAD, pressing the space bar is equivalent to pressing enter. Select this line and fillet it to this line. This line to this line, this line to this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the home tab, layer panel and select the make current button. Click to select this object. Select the line command. Turn on the polar tracking and click this down arrow. Set the angle into 45 degrees. Click this point and move into 45 degrees or snap into this area. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select the trim command, select this line and press enter. Trim off this object. Type R on your keyboard and press enter to invoke the erase option. Select this two line and press enter. Press enter to end the command. Go to the navigation bar and click the zoom extent button. Zoom out a little bit, then click the save button. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the make current button. Click the 2D wall layer to make it the current layer. Start the line command and use the midpoint object snap. Move to the perpendicular object snap, press escape. Start the line command again. Start a line at the midpoint of this line, to the midpoint of this line. Press enter to end the command. Now go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 6 inches on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and offset it up. Select this line, move up this time, type 2 feet 6 inches and press enter. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this line and use the grip to move it at this endpoint. Select this line, use the grip, move it to this endpoint. Press escape. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the trim command. Press enter. Trim off this line, this line, this line, this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 1 foot 6 inches. Press enter. Offset this line to left, both left and the right. Then select this line, move it to the left, and type 1 foot 3 inches. Press enter. Press escape. Now select this line. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the mirror command. At the prompt specifying first point of mirror line, click this endpoint and move the mouse cursor to vertical direction and click. Press enter to accept the default mirror option. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the trim command. Press enter. Trim off these lines, this line. Type R to or click the erase option on the status bar and select this line, this line. Press enter to end the erase and return to the trim command. Trim off this area to clean the drawing more clearly, and trim off all these other areas. Trim these areas to clean up your drawing. You can zoom in and out to look for areas where need to be trimmed. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the navigation bar. This time, let's use a different zoom option. Click this down arrow and look for zoom window. When you do, AutoCAD gives you the prompt specifying first corner. Zoom in into this area and click. And AutoCAD asks you to specify the opposite corner. Click into this area. AutoCAD zoom to the extent of the window that you specify. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save button. We'll continue this project in the next tutorial. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the share button and share it to your friends. And if you have any comment or you have any method you prefer to do the same process, because in AutoCAD you have more options to do something. If you found the process that I use in this tutorial are difficult for you, or you want a specific tutorial, or you have any comments, please leave a comment below. If you want to follow up along this project, or you want any tutorial in my channel, please click the subscribe button to subscribe. I hope to see you in the next tutorial. Thanks very much for watching. Goodbye.